Hello dear Beth, welcome to BeerBest.com Next Gen Beth, and today I am here to discuss about my clinical cases and field experiences to share with you, and I am here to make this video in English languages because you know that some of our technical or professional secrets will not be shared all of the people, so that I am trying to making this video in English languages that all the people not understand or not. I'm trying to just trying to making these videos, and today I am will discussing cases about the black water disease or BQ diseases. You know that this disease is not frequently found in our country, but sometimes it is found because of regular vaccinations. The black water is not frequently available, and we can say that this disease is under control, and but you can sometimes find this disease because of unawareness of about these diseases, and you know that all the farmers are not aware about the vaccinations programs, and sometimes this, and this I will be discussing to this diseases, and this is black water disease. You can find this diseases on BDBets.com videos and BDBets.com videos, and this is videos. You can find some other clinical cases videos which will be helpful to you, and this is the clinical cases I found this in my field experiences, and you know that BQ is if you want to know about the disease more information, you can visit us our diseases, livestock diseases, and in these diseases you will find this black waters about in the article, and you see that these pictures here, the muscles are swell, and if you see these clinical signs, the signs are the fever and the depressions. After seeing this calf, you see that this is the calf is depressed, and depression and inappetence and toxemia. It's a very fatal signs, and cause of death in the toxemia, and progressively unlearning, region of swelling muscle, there is a swelling muscles on the right leg, swelling muscles, and there is a lameness, and myopathy involves in limb musculature, and the initial skin is soft, and maybe peeling edema, and this is also swelling and peeling edema, and present is initial, and the toxemia present subnormal, or sometimes the temperatures will be subnormal, and in my clinical field cases I found that after 2 days or after 1 day that temperature will fall in cases, and the hard respiratories, and signs of about rapidly progressible to 24 to 48 hours, and a few cases survive 3 days. Therapy is instituted. Sudden death, and dehydration, and swelling, toxemia, lameness, and severe death, and you can see that this is a recumbent calf, and inappetence and depressed calf. He is 7 months old. After palpations, the swelling muscles, you can find the sound, and if we can say there is a potch, and this is a typical identical sound, and you can palpate the gash under the skin or intramuscular region, And I treated this calf fastly with the cholera saline. So you see that there is a cholera saline 500. You infuse the cholera saline because of toxemia, and the saline is a very effective for neutralizing that toxins, you know that. And this after the infusion, so the cholera saline, and the calf already stand. Initially the calf was unable to stand, but after giving the treatment very experience of my life. And the farmer is very happy after giving the treatment of cholera saline, which was unable to stand, but after giving the saline, the calf became stand and walk, but it was lameness. Okay, and what should be the treatment? And the treatment, you know that it's a Clostridium chovi, and it's a Clostridium is a gram positive organism, and for drug of choice should be in the penicillin, brocken penicillin or benzene penicillin. That is it's a very effective, and you find that giving the treatment here, and that the penicillin and antibiotic choice kill the vegetative of Clostridium, and drug should be very high level. And though the calf was almost approximately 770 kilo weight, I use 40 lakh of penicillin, 40 lakh of penicillin, and 40 lakh of penicillin, and I gave the injections intramuscular along with the surrounding of this swelling area. And you know that in the swelling area there bacteria may be found, and if antibiotic is directly injected in the swelling area, the bacteria cannot be proliferated, and this will be effective for your, and the disease will not spread to the other region or area. And I gave the 5 days treatment. After 5 days, 3 days of treatment, the owner let me know that the calf was already well, and it is working, but the swelling area remained. And you know that the swelling area will be remain for a few days. And if you want to know more about this, though my video is not very qualified, and you can find this in the disease of videos and the livestock disease videos, veterinary videos, and the livestock videos, or and there is a black quarter, and you can find this video and some other videos, and this is a all I will discuss these videos for you. And there are also an atlas which will help you to find the clinical signs or clinical cases which I found in my field experiences, and this will be helpful. And if you want to know more about the disease, vaccines and medicines available in the market, you can visit these veterinary drugs, these links, and that there is the atlas, and you can find that most of these cases I found and posted. You know that as a veterinary surgeon, I am a general practitioner, and I have to deal with different types of animals, and I am collecting these informations and posting these videos and pictures, images, and the disease informations to share with my fellow veterinarians. And I think this will help you, And you know that BDBets.com is a pioneer in banana service and in our country. And I believe that service, education and research is the missions of BDBets.com. And you will make your innovative online prescriptions by login to the BDBets.com. And you can find educational resources also in after login, veterinary books and visits and other things. And in the veterinary forum, you can also discuss some cases about, you can post also, and you can comment also in this. There is some cases and field cases I'm posted. This is in this binary forum, you can also join for contribute after logging. This you can also find all of this. Hope that it will help you to the video. I'm this is my first videos about training. You should not take it as a training classes or any other cases. I am here just to share my experiences and field experiences which I found, and I think that the field experiences should be shared, and you may find some information or some cases helpful to you. If you have any suggestions, let me know, and your suggestions is valuable for further developing our videos and our websites. And thank you for watching these videos, and hope all of that you will be, and I believe that next generation veterinarian are very much talentful, and they can contribute to our livestock or veterinary services to attain its apex. Thanks dear Beth.